Here I am at W3L Wrestling Showdown in Elgin at the Bishop Mill Hall. This is, of course, a little area on site. It would be very empty otherwise. This is very echoey.
Very echoey,
yes. I think I've done an interview in here with Emily Hayden, Mike Russo, Kevin Williams, and the Tormentor.
Oh, the Tormentor.
The Tormentor.
Did he say much?
He said a lot of things.
Oh.
I didn't understand any of them, but you know. I am joined by W3L heavyweight champion Taylor Bryden, past guest on the podcast.
Yes, past guest.
Exciting. I've had a blast tonight. How's it like? What's it like coming back up to Elgin?
It's good. I like it. You know what? It feels really different. Like, having been in the town hall last time, then we're in the Bishop Mill Hall this time. But the fans in Elgin are always great. Like, they always bring energy, enthusiasm. There's always like diehard locals that I've been seeing coming to Elgin for at least the last 8 years. So it's nice to see familiar faces and see people like come back and join the product and really show respect and some love to W3L.
It is. Well, I was just thinking about it on my way over. Right? First one I came to was September 2012.
Yeah.
And it was in the town hall. And
yes.
I've came every year since because, you know, not just because I live here, but because I enjoy watching wrestling.
Yeah.
It's just easy to see, and that's always a good thing. And get to see yourself as well. The first time I would have seen you, I don't think you were even on the show. No, you were. You were against CJ Hunter.
Yes, I was CJ Hunter.
So this is a long journey. CJ Hunter, and well, I think it was the first half main, and now you're the champ.
The main event. The main event. And title, I'm still earning my stripes as a main eventer.
Well, I mean, you've got a hard challenge now. It's Gaia Hox.
Yes.
If I remember rightly. Someone who I was speaking to Looking Sharp as part of his Dane spotting show, who was heaped the praise on this guy. So I'm very excited for this match. You've already fested Doug Williams recently. So, you know, it's...
Everyone's a bit different, though. Everyone's a bit different. Like, the way that I prepare for Doug is completely different to how I'm going to prepare for a guy like Gaia Hox. He's fast. He's quick. He's agile. And his feet are... probably registered weapons. It's I think the same basic cores there, even though the preparations are different for every single person who's going to end up wrestling. You need to do the groundwork. You need to be looking at what they're doing, looking at what they throw, so that you can already have like a plan B, like a contingency plan, if you will, about what you're going to do to deal with certain challenges that come up. So I'm in the zone. I'm ready to rock tonight. I think I've seen all his stuff, and I think anything he gives me tonight, I can withstand. So yeah.
So by the time this episode comes out, of course, I'm assuming you have retained. We'll find out I do a big montage in these kind of episodes.
Yes.
Of all the photos I take. I was going to do video, but I think if you guys are going to put this out on YouTube for W3L Wrestling Showdown, I think I'll leave it to the professionals for the video.
Wait for the video.
But no, I can't wait. You're doing, like, since we last spoke, you were, I think it was season two maybe, and since then you've just been everywhere, it seems to be. You're fairly going about, because I'm doing the SWN 100, so it's kind of like PWI stuff, and I won't, unless you want me to tell you after the recording. You've done very well. So you're high up there because of your work, because it's about win losses and promotions you've been to and all that kind of stuff, and it's just it's really great to see, just to see since the pandemic ended, to see how much you've went from just, I don't want to say a guy on the roster, to the guy on shows, and you're picking up titles at Reckless Intent, picking up titles at W3L. It's great to see the journey.
Yeah, it's a bit as with everything, like nothing ever ends. The moment you're happy, the moment that you start standing still is the moment that people start going past you. And it's something that I've really realised over the last little while, that if you're not evolving and constantly trying to improve, then you're never going to get anywhere in wrestling. Like, as much as a lot of people won't want to say, but I think the guy that I've seen everywhere this year, like guys like Leighton Buzzard, who's been everywhere, Kez Evans, Jack Morris, guys that have put in so much work and so much dedication to wrestling and so much of their life into it, are starting to reap the rewards. And I'm hoping that I can sort of emulate that, and hopefully this is just a breakthrough year and not the sort of crescendo of this is what I'm going to do. Yeah, I'm hoping to keep going and fire through.
So I won't keep you any longer because you're in the zone, you're ready for Gaia Hox. This is the Christmas edition, this is the Christmas Carnage episode of the SWN Podcast.
Yes.
I'm just going to ask just a random question. What's been the best Christmas present you've ever gotten?
Just off the top of my head, 1999, I walked downstairs, I was 10 years old, and I had opened a little square box, and it was Super Smash Bros, the very first one. And if anybody talks about Christmas to me, that's what I remember, because I ploughed hours in my childhood into that game. And yeah, like that's the one thing that I always remember is that I was Super Smash Bros, and it was something that I'd always wanted.
Perfect. Well, I said I'll leave you. I won't take any more of your time, and I won't let you get right into your match with Gaia Hox. So we'll find out what happens later. But thank you very much, and good luck for 2023. Hopefully, I'll get to speak to you again through the podcast at some point.
Perfect. Thanks very much, Billy. I appreciate that. Thank you very much.